Hello students, today we are going to learn a very important property of triangle, that is sum of any two sides of a triangle is always greater than the third side. Okay, so that means if we consider a triangle, suppose here I am drawing a triangle ABC, then we will find that summation of any two sides of it is greater than the third side. So here, for our convenience, let us consider that BC is the largest side. Okay, what we can see from this figure also, right? BC is considered to be the largest side. So here the statement says that sum of any two sides is greater than the, is always greater than the third side. That means if we can show that for the other two sides, for the summation of other two sides, like for AB plus AC, we get the summation is greater than BC, then obviously the statement will be proved. Because if the statement can be proved for the longest side, that the longest side's length is getting lesser than the summation of the length of the other two sides, then obviously if we consider other pairs of sides and make the summation of their length, then the length will be greater than the length of the remaining one. So hence the statement will be proved if we can show if we can show AB plus AC is greater than BC, because this will be enough to prove the statement, right? As this will happen, so obviously for any other pair, summation of any other pair of sides, we will find that the summation is getting greater than the length of the third remaining one, right? So here, let's consider a perpendicular. For our convenience, we are making this construction, a perpendicular from A to BC. Let's name it as AD. So for proving this statement, we have considered a perpendicular AD from A to BC, right? For our convenience. Then what is the facility? What is the benefit? What do we get by this construction? The entire triangle, look, has been divided into two triangular parts. One is triangle ABD, another one is triangle ACD. So here AD perpendicular to BC is constructed, right? And so we can find these two triangular parts, as I have told you, that is triangle ABD and triangle ACD. And these two triangles are two right angled triangles. Therefore, triangle ABD and triangle ACD, two right angled triangles, because this angle is 90 degree, this angle is 90 degree, as AD is the perpendicular on BC from A, are two right angle triangles. Are formed. Right? Now let's consider these two triangular parts one after another. So, considering this triangular part, triangle ABD, what do we find? AB is the hypotenuse, because this is right angle. We know in a right angle triangle, the side opposite to the right angle is called the hypotenuse, and it is the longest side of a right angle triangle. So AB is the hypotenuse, right? This is the longest side of the right angle triangle. So obviously the length of AB should be greater than BD, because BD is the one of the remaining two sides of the right angle triangle ABD. Therefore, AB must be greater than BD. Actually, AB is greater than BD as well as than AD, right? We are considering BD for our convenience. From triangle ACD, similarly, we find it is also a right angle triangle. AC is the hypotenuse, because AC is the side which is opposite to the right angle. AC is the hypotenuse. Therefore, obviously AC is the longest side. Therefore, AC is greater than DC. Actually, AC is greater than DC as well as AD. We are considering DC for our convenience. So, this is number one, this is number two relation. So, if we add this two, because this less greater sign is in the same direction, so we can make the summation between these two relations, and hence adding this two, we get AB plus AC is greater than BD plus DC. Now, BD plus DC combiningly obviously will give us BC. Therefore, AB plus AC is greater than BC. And hence, for the smaller two sides, AB and AC, because we considered BC is the longest side, so comparatively smaller sides where AB and AC of the triangle ABC, we find the relation is satisfied. The relation is proved, right? So obviously, this proof is enough to state that for summation of any other pair of sides, any other two sides, we will find that the summation is getting greater than the measurement of the remaining side. And hence it is proved that sum of any two sides of a triangle is always greater than the measurement of the third side. This is a very important property of a triangle. Today we are going to discuss about the construction of triangle with three sides, three given sides. Now make sure, students, if you are given three sides of a triangle for constructing it, not necessarily that always you will be able to construct a triangle with those three sides, because we know there must be a relation among the given three sides, and the relation states that summation of any two should be greater than the third one. So let's first take the first question, which asks us that verify whether you can construct a triangle with the segments, obviously line segments, of measurements 6 centimeter, 4 centimeter, 2 centimeter. So we are given three segments and we are asked to verify that whether we can construct a triangle with these three segments or not. Okay. So let's judge. We know summation of any two segments should be greater than the third one. So if we consider the least one and the one which is just greater than it, suppose we are considering that is 2 centimeter and 4 centimeter. So then adding this 2 centimeter and 4 centimeter, adding the length of these two segments, we get 6 centimeter, which is equal to the measurement of the third side. The measurement of the third side, of the third segment, of the third segment. So obviously we can't draw a triangle with these three segments, because this is mandatory that this kind of relation should be there among the given segments, that is sum of any two should be greater than the sum of length of any two should be greater than the measurement or length of the other one. If this condition is not satisfied, then we cannot draw a triangle with the given line segments. So here we can't draw the triangle with these measurements of line segments. Now, in this question, we have to verify that whether a triangle ABC with AB 6 cm, BC 7 and C 8 cm can be constructed or not, by the same way as we have seen earlier. So if that condition, that sum of any two segments is greater than the third segment, is satisfied here for this given measurements, then we have to construct it. Okay. So let's first verify. Here we are given AB 6, BC 7 and CA 8 cm. Okay. So, we have to show that whether summation of any two is greater than the third one or not. So, let's take the least one, which is 6 cm here, and the one which is just greater than the least measurement. So, here we find 6 cm plus 7 cm, which is 13 cm. So, obviously, it is greater than the remaining length, that is 8 cm. And by the same way, if we find the summation of 7 and 8, which is 15, which will obviously be greater than the remaining one, that is 7 cm plus 8 cm, is 15 cm, obviously greater than the remaining one, means 6 cm. And by the same way, we find that 6 cm plus 8 cm is 14 cm, and which is obviously greater than the measurement of the remaining one, that is 7 cm. So, sum of any two sides is greater than the third segment. Any two segments is greater than the third segment. Hence, the triangle can be constructed because the given segments, the measurements of the given segments are satisfying the relation which should be there among the three sides of a triangle. So, now we have to construct it because we have seen that the triangle can be constructed with the given segments. So, here first of all the measurements of the three segments AB, BC and CA are taken by using scale, and here I have used pen for making the photo clear. Usually for any geometrical construction we use pencil, right? So, here first of all the segment BX is taken. Now, if we consider a rough sketch of the triangle what we are going to construct, then we can see that if we think the vertex at the top, then we can see that this should be the arrangement of the other two vertices. So, here this segment is AB, this is BC, this is CA. So, according to this configuration, let's draw the or let's construct the triangle. So, first of all, according to this rough configuration, we get BC should be taken as the base. So, let's take the measurement BC by using this compass. So, here measurement of BC is taken. And I have already taken a base, which is BX. Here, the vertex B is considered. So, we can take this B as the center, and with this radius of measurement BC, an arc can be constructed. It is cutting, it is intersecting BX at a certain point. So, obviously this one, this segment is drawn by using compass, and hence this vertex will give us C vertex. Okay. Now, we have to go for getting the vertex A. So, A is the intersection of BA and CA, right? This rough configuration says us. So, let's take the measurement of BA. And again, taking B as center. Why B as center? Because in BA, we can find B is the common vertex, right? So, we can use this one for center, as center. And then, with the radius BA, an arc is drawn. Because we want to get A above BC. So, here, the arc is drawn above BC. Now, we know that A is the intersection point of BA and CA. So, now we have to draw this CA. So, let's take the measurement of CA, which will be treated as the radius. And in CA, C is the common vertex, so we can take C as the center, and with CA radius, the arc is drawn, which intersect, these two arcs intersect each other at a certain point. Obviously, this is A point, because A is the intersection of AB or BA and CA. So, now, this A is joined with B as well as with C. And hence the triangle ABC is constructed with the given measurement. So, here we can write triangle ABC is constructed where AB equals to AB was of measurement 6 cm, This one was of 7 and this one was of 8. BC was 7 and CA was 8. AB equals to 6 cm. BC equals to 7 cm and CA equals to 8 cm. And hence the configuration is completed.